Who am I? I am a rabbi. How do you become a rabbi? Well, it goes like this. You go to school when you're growing up. And when you grow up, you go to rabbi school. What do I do? And why am I making a movie about kosher that is deadly? You thought all rabbis sit in synagogues and tend to their flock. Well, rabbis are a lot like doctors. Synagogue rabbis are like general practitioners. They take care of many tasks. Their main job is taking care of the needs of the community. Then there are the specialists, rabbi specialists. They just handle one subject mainly. That's where I come in. I myself am a blue-collar rabbi. What? You never heard of that? That's because I just made it up. What do I do? Well, what I mainly do is travel around and inspect big, giant, huge, massive food factories. This is my day. I usually take a car to a plane, to a car, to a factory, to a car, to a plane, to a car, to a factory, to a car, to a plane, to a car, to home. Let me tell you what kosher is. Kosher is a biblical law not to mix meat and milk. There are also some species of animals and fish that are not kosher intrinsically. I inspect factories to make sure that the processes and ingredients adhere to this standard. I have to go to the places where these food products are made, wherever they're made, and they are made all over this world. So when I was offered to go to a factory that was processing fish oil in the middle of the Bering Sea, one of the most dangerous waters on this planet, I thought, why not? God doesn't need a boat to get rid of me. The Bering Sea is located between Alaska and Russia. First, I would fly from Seattle to Anchorage, and then take a small plane 3 hours to the island of Unalaska. What? You never heard of Unalaska? It's there. My trip started out with a bang, a really big one. Just before my flight, a volcano erupted, and all the flights were grounded. Was I discouraged? I was even more excited to go. Well, finally made it. We're leaving in 2.5 hours. This boat is 265 feet long, and 130 people are on this boat. Well, we're off. We are going to the fishing grounds, 450 miles northwest towards Russia. It will take us 36 hours to get there. I can't express the loneliness that you feel when you leave land for the last time, going to nowhere.
It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world.
My first day at sea. Fishing trips are around 2 weeks. There isn't any way off the boat. There isn't any helicopter pads. Rescue is 2 hours away. If you fall in the ocean here, God forbid, you can last only 2 minutes because of the temperature of the water. With a survival suit, you can last 2 hours. Now you know why I call it Deadliest Kosher. Let me now take you on a journey into kosher supervision. I went on this boat to determine whether this company could make kosher fish oil or not. What determines a kosher fish is that the species have to have fins and scales, like salmon, tuna, halibut, pollock, to mention a few. Some non-kosher species are lobster, crab, catfish, shrimp, and krill. Krill is a type of shrimp, which brings us to an important kosher question. How can we certify that all fish that was made into oil had fins and scales in the middle of the ocean? This boat is a factory trawler, which means they catch fish and process and pack into boxes ready for sale. I want to focus on a unique kosher question that arose. This is pollock. Pollock is a kosher species. Fishing season B starts after the pollock finish mating. During mating, the pollock don't eat. After mating, the pollock go on a binge eating krill as the main source of food. Now, krill is not kosher. Most fish oil companies cook whole fish to render into oil. This company only uses the internal organs to render into oil. When the company uses whole fish, the amount of non-kosher in the stomach is so small compared to the weight and mass of the skin, head, bones of the fish. It does not factor in the final kosher product, but when a company uses just the internal organs and the fact that fish gorge themselves, the krill could render the entire oil non-kosher. Then we could not certify the oil as kosher, and the company would have to abandon their much anticipated kosher project. Now, with the great demand for omega-3 in the food and vitamin industry, a lot was riding on my investigation. 36 hours from land. Now, I want to warn you, if you're squeamish about looking at fish being dissected, then you probably should fast forward this film. No fish were hurt in the filming of this video, but I'm not sure you can hurt them if they're dead already. We are now going to investigate what's in the stomachs of the pollock to see how much krill is in there. First, we have to have an anatomy lesson.
Alaska pollock, right?
Broken down, the stomach is broken down, so you can try and find see the bigger ones in there. They're not as broken down. That's the krill.
Amazing.
Well, I didn't know they were that color.
So yeah, this is a good, you can see how he's very long. So she is still recovering from hay season. As they feed more and more, they'll get thicker. They'll get thicker down the back. Their fat level will increase. Their livers will become whiter when they're still got some redness to them and they're not very thick. As the healthier they get, the liver will become whiter and whiter.
What's this?
We have like the... They have the roe sac, the intestines basically. This is whatever, I can't remember exactly what the name is, but it's attached to the stomach.
You know what they do, what it does?
No. Okay. Then you have the bile sac right here.
That's for digestion?
Bile sac's for digestion?
Yeah.
Basically like our gallbladder.
This is my plan to determine how much krill are in the entrails of 100 fish. I'm going to dissect 100 fish. I'm going to take out the innards. I'm going to separate the stomachs. I'm going to extract the krill from all the stomachs, put the stomachs back into the guts, and then I'm going to weigh each one. After I figure a way how to wash away the half-digested krill from the whole krill. Half-digested krill, according to kosher law, is considered part of the fish. Whole krill is a problem. I had to figure out a way of how to wash out the digested krill and to retain the whole krill.
There is 100 fish guts. 100 fish guts. I'm now going to take out the stomachs and take the krill out of the stomachs. And that's it for now. This is 100 stomachs. There's a single one. I'm going to split it right here. I'm going to do it with one hand. Then I'm going to squeeze. Real. Wow. That looks very digested. The little black dots are the eyes of the krill.
I poured the krill in the strainer, and Friday when we did this, it kept the whole krill, and not and half of krill's decomposed krill washed through the screen. But this has taken a long time to drain out. But eventually will. I don't want to disturb them by mixing it or touching it, so I'm going to wait. And at the end, we should know how many whole krill were in the stomach. In the meantime, I took a measurement of all the krill, decomposed and not, in case this didn't work. This is what's left. It didn't really work like the small sample. So I'm going to have to take it upstairs and go through it with the tweezers and see if I can pick out. It should take me a couple hours. Sure, then I'll run the numbers from the whole cup, the whole krill, before I put it in the strainer and see what I come up with. Okay, this is what's left of the screen. It's very matty. It's probably impossible to pick out the whole ones. But I would say that there's a lot of whole ones in here. And because it's matty, I would think it more. But I don't. Not everything in here is whole. So I'm going to measure what's here also and make a measurement and see if we can figure out if it's... See, even if it's a little digested, it's sort of matty. But you can see some bodies. But I don't know if I can determine whether they're just by trying to separate them, to break them, doesn't give you a true judgment of it. But for sure, not all these are whole at all. If you say half, I would be amazed because, you know, there's very little that are whole. You know, I looked at the individual fish, very little that are whole. The next challenge was that we found out that water is added to the innards before it goes into the cooker. So the question is, how much water is added compared to 100 fish and 100 stomachs that I emptied the krill out of? Finding out how fast the fish cutters are rated for determined that if we take 15 seconds of water from the input pipe and add it to the innards of the fish, we should get our basis for our figures. Once we crunched the numbers, we decided the krill was not significant and we could go ahead and approve this company to make kosher fish oil. on the next episodes of Deadliest Kosher. Danger.
Navy! Jacob! Here. Baba! Here. Mahamadou! Oh. Yes. Yes.
Educational.
So these are up forward.
These are down below, but I mean they come from the hall here. They go down. You know, we can lift it.
Comedy. Music and dance. Okay.